This morning in the Rhode Show kitchen, Chef Corey Fesco is here from Public Kitchen and Bar, and we are making caramelized pumpkin bread pudding, correct?
Yes, we are.
How you doing, buddy?
How are you today?
Nice to see you, Corey. Thank you very much for being here. And this recipe is featured in this month's issue of Rhode Island Monthly,
it
correct?
It is.
So this is, my mouth is watering already.
I'm getting ready for the fall, and I'm going to be putting on the new menu coming up in a couple weeks.
Love it. Well, take us through some of the ingredients we'll be working with here today.
Sounds good. I brought everything pre-prepared, but just so I can show you guys how we're doing it.
Awesome.
I have all the ingredients for the bread pudding over here.
Love it.
We have the cream, the pumpkin, the sugar, the eggs, and the caramel. A couple spices for the end. And we're going to also do a little maceration of apples with whiskey and sugar and cinnamon. Then I have a little bit of prep for a walnut brittle. Corn syrup, water, vanilla, butter. A little bit of toasted walnuts.
Beautiful. I can tell by looking at you that you are a culinary master, ready to whip up a storm here. How are things going over there at the Public Kitchen and Bar?
Things are going fantastic. Me and the crew are working on a new menu and always working on getting ready for the new season, because this time of year it's going to get real busy with parties and weddings and all such.
Well, that's really the key to it all. When you have an establishment that's serving food and whatnot, your challenge, you've always got to be coming up with the next great thing,
you always have to be ready. Right when you get done with one thing, you got to start another.
That's right. But that must be fun for you, because you can let your creativity shine and kind of go nuts with the menu.
Never a dull moment.
Yeah, and you probably find that the people, the patrons that come in, they're very loyal and they respond well to your new ideas.
Yeah, and they're very appreciative of the place that we've opened and started with our global influence menu. So
love it. Well,
it's a little bit different.
A little later on, I'll be putting my apron on, doing my best to pretend I know how to assist you in here.
I'll show you the way.
All right, I will follow his lead. This is Chef Corey Fesco. Of course, Rhode Island Monthly features this great recipe this month, which this guy will be cooking up all morning long. You do not want to miss it. For now, back over to you.
And we are back in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning, thanks to our friends at Rhode Island Monthly Magazine. They've brought us Chef Corey, Public Kitchen and Bar. We got caramelized pumpkin bread pudding. We heard about this yesterday. We're like, what? Sounds really good. And it looks great.
It's that time of year. I brought everything already prepared, but I'm going to show you a couple of ways of how we prepare the bread pudding, how we make the brittle, and then we'll plate it there.
All right, so what do we need to do right now?
Right now, I'm starting the brittle. I'm just getting the water to a boil.
Okay.
What I'm going to do right now is I'm going to mix these eggs together.
Right, you know what? We'll switch spots.
Just to get these eggs broken up a little bit.
Okay, about how many eggs are we going to just...
I'm going to do 3 eggs.
Okay.
3 eggs.
Those in. And how long does this have to go here?
Right there, that's just on... Until I get this mixed, I'm going to turn it up and we'll start that process.
All right, okay.
So I...
Put that in there.
Put that right in there, get these whipped up so everything incorporates nicely.
Mix that through. And then what kind of bread are we using? Because is it all about the bread?
Funny thing, you can use any bread for bread pudding. You can use leftover waffles, you can use croissants.
So anything works?
Anything. I'm using brioche today because it soaks up the liquid nice.
Okay.
And then to this, we're going to add the cream.
All right. That is whole cream?
Yep, that's heavy cream, yep.
And if you're going to do it, go all the way.
Go all the way.
Go all the way.
You can add half and half, you can add milk, it's the same kind of thing. So pumpkin?
Pumpkin.
Yep. Raw sugar.
Okay.
The caramel sauce, actually.
Right.
Adds a little depth of flavor.
Looks good.
We have a little bit of spice mixture, ginger, allspice, nutmeg, and cinnamon.
To real give it that fall...
Yeah, that fall feel.
Fall feel to it.
And I'm also going to do a little fresh nutmeg in here.
Okay.
Once we get everything in the bowl, we can mix it all together. We can pour it right over this. Yep, get it all mixed together.
Yep. And then you're going to
pour it right over the bread pudding.
Okay, and let that soak in.
Let that soak for a few minutes, and then we're going to put it in the oven in a few moments. And as this sits, I'm going to start doing that brittle.
Okay, all right. So he's going to mix this up. We're going to put this over the bread. We're going to mix this together and also talk about the restaurant itself, because they got a lot of great things going on. In the meantime, back to you. We are back in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. Rhode Island Monthly. Chef Corey is here from Publix Kitchen and Bar. Caramelized pumpkin bread pudding. Doesn't get any better than that. It's
time of the season.
Time of the season.
That's right. We're in a full state of mind.
Yes, we are.
All right.
What do we need?
Actually, everything is pretty much prepped.
All right.
Just because, for sake of time, I just heated up the bread pudding so it's nice and warm, not too hot, so it doesn't burn you.
Right.
I have all the prep over here so we can plate it. And
okay, so when we left last time, you were pouring it into the bread. You had it soak for a little while.
I had it soak for the time that you were gone.
Right.
And when I put it into buttered ramekins in the oven, it's baking currently, so you'll start to smell it pretty soon.
Got it.
But for the sake of time, I had pre-made some so we can place it.
And how long do those have to sit in there?
In that little mold, probably like 10 to 12 minutes.
Oh, so not bad at all.
Yeah,
you know what's great about this is that it seems simple enough people can maybe tackle this at home.
They
definitely
want to
try it for the weekend. Even somebody like me, wouldn't screw this up.
It is actually, and I put the recipe on there, and it's really well written. So I'm, because my chef helped me out with it. So
you have guests over there to Costa de Kirby.
Yes, you're one.
You're going to make some bread pudding.
You'll be all that's right. With the thousands of people lining up,
we can sit around and watch Jeopardy and have bread pudding.
That's right. We have Fortune Jeopardy hour, my favorite hour of the day on WPRI 12.
So what do we want to do right now?
Right now we're going to start to plate it.
Okay.
I'm going to put it right in the middle here. It's going to unmold nice and easy.
Switch places.
I like the way you did that so seamlessly.
But I'm going to flip it over so you can see the nice.
Okay.
Table. You don't want it to be too hot, like you were saying.
You don't
want
it to be too hot.
A little bit.
Because when you're enjoying a dessert, nobody wants to burn themselves.
No.
A steak, a pasta, but a dessert, you know, I've had comments that it's a little too hot, so so now I say that I'm going to some little caramel.
Okay. Cool.
This is the plate. We just bought these for the fall because they're kind of like nice for the fall.
Very nice.
Rather than your regular white plate.
Right.
You know, it's great, too. It makes an awesome dessert, like you
looks
said,
good.
That people could even make it for a snack or something.
Oh, of course.
You know, it looks like it's quite delightful.
And the way the recipe's written, you can change anything you want. You can put apples in it. You can put nuts in it.
Uh-huh.
You can make it any flavor you want. You can even add flavors like whiskey, rum.
Now you've got my attention.
Now, yes. Now he's into it. Now he's
hey, there's
into
plenty
it.
Of whiskey in here right here. So I have some apples here, that local Macintosh.
Awesome.
That I put a little cinnamon, nutmeg, and whiskey in there.
It's apple picking time.
I didn't cook it out because... You know, in the fall reminds me of whiskey, pumpkin, apples.
Sure.
So I decided to put everything on the plate all at once.
Okay.
And the public kitchen and bar, people out there can come on by and see you guys?
Yes, they can. The fall menu doesn't start until the end of this month, but I am specialing this dessert all the way to the end so we can get everybody, like, into the zone. And
that's good, because last time you said you were here last time, you had a bunch of people come in that night because they were looking for the...
And hopefully the same thing will happen
the candy
tonight,
bar
you know, and we'll,
that
we'll,
you were making.
Yep, candy bar last time, yep.
That looks great.
It smells great, too. I mean, I can get the aroma over here.
And as it bakes, you guys are going to have plenty of smells in the entire place,
it's
probably.
It's terrific.
Put that on.
A little bit of crunch, you know, because every dessert, every dish, I think, needs crunch, soft texture crunch, all that stuff.
He's an artiste. Yeah. I love it. Look, it looks awesome.
And then just a little bit of powdered sugar.
Looks good.
Very nice. Dousing
great.
It. Looks too good to eat. It's so picturesque. It's perfect.
We'll give it a shot, though.
Seriously, I know you like sweets.
I do like sweets. That I do like. All right. In the meantime, while we're taking a look at that, let's talk about the restaurant stuff. What do you guys have going on?
We're basically taking what we have currently on the menu, and we're changing it. Today we have like a beet salads for the summer, but we're going to turn it into a fall salad.
Right.
Instead of using like fresh ingredients like lemon and ricotta slotted cheese, we're going to use... like a roasted walnut sauce. We're going to use a apple vinaigrette, stuff
sure.
like that. So, and then we're also going to be doing like a pork tenderloin on the menu with all kinds of fall ingredients,
okay.
brown buttered mushrooms, stuff like that.
So there's a wide variety of things for anyone who wants to go into the restaurant and check it out.
For the first time since we've been open, the entire menu will be changing, not just...
Oh, wow.
Well, just when your loyal customers have thought that they've seen it all, you change it up and there's new stuff for them to try.
And it's
great.
Same kind of like on the same kind of level. So it's not gonna be like, why'd you take that off? But we have this now. So it's something that they can still come by and love us too. So.
And if anybody doesn't know where you are, where are you guys located?
We're right across from the State Building downtown at the Renaissance Hotel. And it's actually kind of in the basement. You'll see the patio outside. There's an outside seating.
Right. Yep.
And you can park. There's complimentary valet parking for you if you want to come by.
Complimentary valet parking.
Trying this. Give me a fork.
We're going to swing this over here.
Yeah, definitely.
Here.
That fan's a little hot.
I'm going to put this right here.
I've made the sacrifice.
So are you digging it?
I'm going to try it.
We only
had one fork left.
I'm sorry.
Oh, there's plenty of forks.
Back off.
Oh my God! You
is
know
it
what?
Good?
I gotta sit down.
Hang on, I'm going to
get in there.
We're gonna grab one out of here too.
Those are the forks, the ones with the. We need
we'll
a
grab a little bit. There we go.
Good man.
Drum roll. Let's taste.
Oh yeah. Come on, man.
And it's good.
Give it up for Chef.
Oh, really good.
Corey Fesco, of course. This recipe will be in this month's issue of Rhode Island Monthly. He is from the Public Kitchen and Bar. We'll have this recipe for you guys at WPRI.com.